Welcome to Tennis Spin, where we put our spin on your tennis. Today, we're going to be talking about dampeners. Here you see are the various dampeners that are on the market. These are the most popular, and you see these everywhere. You see on the far left, the simple rubber band that Andre Agassi and Brad Gilbert help promote and use to this day on their own rackets. And then you see the simple dampeners next to those. And then you see the more heavier gauge dampeners as you move to the right. So what are the differences in these dampeners? Well, dampeners mainly take out the sound. So instead of hearing a ping noise without the dampener, you hear a more of a thud noise. So they call it a dampener. Why do they call it a dampener? Well, without anything here on the bottom string, when the ball strikes the strings will resonate. So it'll cause a ping noise and it will vibrate a little bit. Now, when that vibration happens without a dampener, it's going to go all the way through to the handle and you will feel that. Now, the people who don't use dampeners and don't like dampeners like to have that feel. So vibration is equals to feel. So people like myself who don't use a dampener, I can't play with a dampener because it just changes the whole dynamic of the ball striking the strings for me. It actually mutes it for me where I'm not sure where on the face I'm hitting it. So, but I know that that pinging noise drives people crazy and they have to put a dampener on. So something like this rubber band is like the minimalist you can use. So you'll still feel something. It's basically just grabbing a hold of a couple strings and allowing for a little bit of the feel to come through. So this would be the minimalist dampener. As you can see on the table here, there are different shapes and sizes. Now, for people who kind of want a minimalist type of dampener, this Pete Sampras circle and this Babolat circle would allow for a little bit of the feel to come through. And with the Babolat one, you can actually change it if you wanted to. Now this middle plug, you can actually take out or put back in, depending on how much you want to dampen it. And then the rest of these shapes and sizes, the bigger they are, the more they dampen. Now, if you're one of those people who keeps losing dampeners when you're playing, dampeners like that small one there and some of these circles, they do tend to fly out of the racket if you hit them. They will just fly off and you won't be able to find it sometimes. Whereas the big ones like this Dunlop, those will stay on. They're beefy and they will stay on. Now as you move over to the table towards the right, these are very, very heavy duty dampeners. Now, it started with this one back in the day. You strung this along the bottom line of your racket, and it basically took out all types of feel, took out all types of vibration. And then somebody thought, well, if one's good, two's better. So doubly. So you put this on your racket, you won't feel a thing. And then there's different, you know, the head makes their own, which is like an accordion, does the same job. Babolat makes a Vibra-Kill. You see the little beads in there. What that does is it absorbs the shock. When the ball releases from the strings, those things shake so you don't feel the vibration. And then Wilson has their shock trap, which is essentially the same thing as any of these. You string it through the bottom, and it basically deadens out a lot of the vibration, a lot of the feel. Hit pause. Okay. So I get asked every day to put on a dampener. So I'm gonna show you how to put on a dampener. What I do is, so rules of the USTA, it has to go under the last string here, the last cross string here, as they call it. So it has to be under here. You take the dampener, and it's got a slit on the side of it, right? All the way around. You put this first slit into that main string and you push it in, okay? And then you take your fingers and you move that out of the way, and then you jam the other slit in. See how it is, right? And then you jam the top into that string up there, just like that, and then you straighten it back out. So that's the proper way to do it. That will dampen the most out of, you know, pretty much everything. If you want a dampener, but you hate the sound and you want a bit of the feel, what you do is you take that dampener and you move it to the bottom. This will take out some of the sound, but allow for a little bit more of the feel to come through. For this dampener to be most effective, it should be in the center. So if there's six holes on the bottom, it's got to go in the center too. If there's eight, it's still got to go in the center too to be most effective. Now, with something like this, now it still has to be centered. It still has to look like that in order for it to be effective. Now, you see kids that put dampeners all over the head. You know, you see it up here and you see it on the side. I mean, that's all fine and dandy when you're a kid. You're pretty much using it as a decoration at this point. But I've seen people put it on the sides. I mean, as long as you could do whatever you want, as long as you're not playing a sanctioned match, then, I mean, it doesn't really matter. Whatever psychologically you think will help you, do it. But if you're playing a match, dampener's got to go below that last line. Thank you for watching Tennis Spin, where we put our spin on your tennis.